I never made a decision. I never wanted to become a therapist. I was an architect, and I divorced my husband, architect, and then I was with my three children, small children, and I thought, now I go and I learn about psychology, and I attended the lectures in Jung Institute, but I didn't want to become a therapist, absolutely not. I just wanted to learn. And then I found, maybe I could do this training. And when you do the training, after the middle exam, one has to work under supervision. And when I started to work, I had the full practice, just like this. And I said to myself, maybe I can earn my life in this way. Because to be an architect with three small children was extremely difficult, you know. So that was, it was not a decision. It was an adaptation to life circumstances, if you want so. The first book was about houses. And that's the second book. And the third book was about the garden. Yes.
And did you use your previous experience as an architect
to the garden? Yes, very much, because but I said that the Santa is a little soul garden. This I said, yes, here I made the connection. It's like a little garden. Because the garden, the word garden comes from gordo and means to fence in. And to fence in a piece of land in the wilderness, you know. To make a garden, it means to cultivate a piece of land. And that's more or less the same thing here. We live in a time period where time has no more the same value as it had before. We are short running, huh? Everything should be immediate. So even a therapy should be short and immediately should change. It's like a miracle, a magician, but that's not what it is. And therefore today, a psychotherapy method, like Sandplay, like Jungian therapy, like Freudian, that uses a lot of time, needs a lot of time, because we want a deep going change in the personality. It needs a lot of time and dedication. And you know that the structure of the brain does not change like this. We have to work again and again and again and again until our brain has changed, you know this. So the most difficult thing today is the idea of people, in no time I can fix something and then it's okay. And the second problem is the law. The law, the legal aspect of psychotherapy, we have to learn this and this and this and this and even more. And these laws make the freedom. They, in a way, let's say the insurance of the health insurance pays, let's say, 30 or 40 hours. It's okay, but if I need 50 hours, what then? You see, all these legal aspects are necessary, but it is not really appropriate for the human psyche, because our psyche is slow. We need 15, 20 years to grow up. Huh? And then we should change something in 10 hours. That's history is very, very important because we are embedded, or we live in a historical time. If you go back to the beginning of the Jungian psychology, that was during or just after the First World War, and then during the Second World War, and this had an enormous influence. You know, all the changes in the society, and let's take the development of the women, how they had to then to change again and again. You know, during the war they had to be strong, they had to do everything, and then after the war they went back. So they suffered. Of the history is extremely important. And I tell you an example. I was recently, also a year ago, in China, and I asked the young students, they are 22, 24, I asked them about, yeah, and what about the history in psychology? We don't have time for this, they said. And I found this I couldn't understand this. History and culture are part of our psyche, of our brain. We are very much influenced by this. I mean, I work with the Romanian students, and they have different problems from our students. It depends how old they are. How did they experience the time of the communism? Was the influence from father and mother? You know, that was different from our Swiss or, yeah? And the Swiss people have also a specific attitude in life because we were not in the war. The war was around us, and it creates a specific mentality. Every country, every time, the spirit of the time, you see it in architecture, you see it in the psyche. I mean, Freud today would be different. He was a man of his time, Jung too. There are two aspects, let's say. From the personal point of view, if you repress a person, if you humiliate a person, you can be sure that the person tries to hit back. So the German people were humiliated. After the First World War, they were put down, and then came somebody who said, but you will be the one. Huh? So it was the suffering psyche heard something, and yeah, and then, yeah. It's the same thing all over. But it's also in the psyche something, that's the principle of the psyche, that if you repress something, it starts to. If you repress your anger, let's say, somewhere it starts to cook, it starts to grow, and then, in the right moment, it explodes. So that is why we try to find out what is repressed and what is dangerous there, because it could explode. So I think he saw, in a certain moment, he understood that here is something very dangerous going on. And this will be an enormous danger for the world, yes? And I think we are not far from this moment. It's just not in Europe, it's somewhere else, you know. It's quite difficult to say. Let's rather say what we emphasize, what we, and that's our intellect, our, yeah, rational mind. And with the rational mind, we repress the senses and the body. That's why we have so many also depressed people. And we think that the meaning of life comes, somebody is giving you this, huh? We are not searching for the meaning of life. And Jung says in somewhere, a human being cannot live without a meaning in life. And you see that we have so many depressed people. And in the hospitals, you see the depression, it is because they have no meaning, no sense in life. That's one thing. The second danger, I think, is the cell phone. Let's say so. Because you can look at children or other people. They are no more living in themselves. They are ongoing connected to something. They walk in the street, they don't see you, but they see their handy. Huh? It's a danger. And the other danger is the computer. People don't think anymore. You go to Wikipedia. Yeah. You have it, take it out, copy it in your paper, and then you have a clever paper. So I think the reflection, the thinking, the independent, personal life or development is disturbed. That's what I think. And you see all these children, they eat Ritalin, huh? Because they are nervous. Why are they nervous? If you ongoing play with your handy, with your this, with your computer, with your games, can you be peaceful and quiet? No. The brain gets disturbed because our brain is something slow. It needs peace. And we need sleep to recover. That's what I think is the danger of our time, the restlessness. It brings something interesting. It brings 1 hour of total peace. Believe me, lots of people don't have 1 hour of total peace in a week because there is no disturbance in the session. And also for the therapist, you can concentrate on one person and everything little what happens, and it's never boring. For me, it's so interesting to observe what's going on in peace. Yeah. It's difficult to become a good therapist. Somebody who is just fiddling around in the sand, that everybody can do this. But a Sandbach therapist needs a theoretical basis of psychology. If it is Freudian or Jungian, doesn't matter, but it needs a basis because sand play is a technique. It has no psychological theory, sand play. The theory we take is the Jungian theory. So let's say the worldview or the philosophy behind is the Jungian. Otherwise, but sand play, each child can play in the sand, it has a good effect on the child. You need to be a licensed psychotherapist before. You need to have a license in a country. And then you do your own sandplay process to experience what it means for you. And then you start to work with people under supervision. And you do learn what it is, and the supervisor and you are in dialogue. And then when you have enough experience, you write, also for the Sandplay Society, you write at the end a case. And in this case report, you need to show what you see in the sandplay, the transference, the counter-transference, everything must be clear there and must be consistent, yeah. And then, if it is accepted, you get the certificate.